We're going to look today at Psalms. We opened up today with this, Psalms 150. But I think in life we see all sorts of different phrases, right? I love watching sports, and I'm as loud as I am watching sports that I am here on Sunday mornings. Just to let you know, that's my personality. I just get excited, but I definitely get excited about God. But sports, you know, I get excited. Anybody watch the fight last night? There was a big fight. I saw the fight last night too. It was good. I don't know what the results mean, one way or another. The ultimate boxer beat a guy that doesn't box. So, you know, I don't know, but it was a good fight. It lasted, 11 rounds? But it was some exciting moments and cheering off with different things. Or, I don't know, we have a few parents in here. Rachel, when she's working with different kids, you know, I know there's some different moments of praises with little kids. Like the time that the kid take the first step, right? That's a big moment. Everybody tries to capture it on Facebook Live, or you know, send it. You get all these moments. I have a lot of friends that are having kids, and so you know, we get all these different first moments. The first word that they said, or how many know the first time they potty on the potty? That's something they rejoice about. You know, no more diapers. It's exciting. We get excited about. But Psalms is a book full of praises, full of things. David going his ups and his down, and he's like, hey, God is good. When he's down, he's like, oh, God is still good. When it's up, hey, you know what? It's because of God. Over and over again, singing praises. And so in Psalms 150, we're going to see here, there's some elements of when we should praise, where we should praise, who should be praising God. And I think most of us know the answer, but I just wanted to be an encouraging thing this morning. We meditate on this and say, hey, let it be like a praise serum, you know, squeezed into us, that we just get affected by the virus of praise. That we can't stop but do anything but praise the Lord. I think it's a good goal for us. Let's read this morning Psalms 150. It says this, praise the Lord. Praise him in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of trumpets. Praise him with the harp and with the lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and with the pipes. Praise him with the clashes of cymbals. Praise him with the resounding cymbal. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And in the end again, praise the Lord. Amen. I'm excited that we have now a drummer. You know, I used to play the djembe on Sunday morning, but it's so nice to have somebody up there hitting the cymbals every once in a while. Get a little loud. Have the bass going. You know, it's going to get exciting. I won't get too far into this because I know that's what I have to say later. But it's going to be exciting when we have an even greater, fuller expression of worship on Sunday morning. All the instruments coming together. Voices singing. You know, we had a whole choir up here. That would be great. It would love it. It would,
man.
Resounding praise to God. Amen. So this Psalms here, Psalms 150, is actually the same verse, same size as the beginning of the Psalms. You know that? The beginning of Psalms 1 is all about meditating on God and meditating on his word. And when we do so, when we meditate on him, then we become like a strong tree that produces fruit in season. We're sturdy and we're strong. And then he ends this with the purpose of the conclusion that it's going to be a psalm, a design that we would assist, that our duty, our part of who we are is to praise God. The psalmist himself, when he's writing this, he's full of praises. I mean, it's six verses, but it lists praise God 13 times. Praise him, praise him. He's excited. Hey, let's praise God. And as we look at this, we see that some of it was written maybe for as a song for the Levites. You know, if you study the Old Testament, you know, we got different tribes of Israel, and the Levites were the priests. They were the ones that went before the Lord. They were the ones that sang praise to the Lord. They were the ones that got everybody excited about the things of God and the presence of God. And so whether this is intended for the Levites, we know that each one of us, if we have given our lives to the Lord, we are a royal priesthood. Man, so we are the priests of the Lord. We are to take the same duties that the priests had, to go before the Lord, to say the prayers. That's why every Sunday, I mean, I can't stop praying. There's more things to pray about. There's more things to present the Lord about, whether it be a request, Lord, do this, or whether it be, God, you're just awesome. I mean, we can't stop praying. I mean, that's part of our duty. That's part of who we are.
Yeah.
We say we're a family servant. We are priests of the Lord. glory to Him, bringing honor to Him, worshiping Him, singing, praying on behalf of the people who are around us. It is a great and a necessary duty to praise.
Yes.
A duty which should not be employed or not, it shouldn't be just think about as something small, but it's something that should be great upon us. And so let's go line by line through Psalms 150, and let's get this inside of us. I was praying, God, let it be like a praise syrup, you know, like just get infected with praise this morning. You guys ready for that? I hope so. I hope we get this. So first off, we got to look at this and say, where is God deserving of praise? And it says here, from the sanctuary. And we know at the time of the Old Testament, there was a sanctuary where God's presence lied, where the priest would go before them and lay before the sins of the people. And there was a moment there that the presence of God would come. And it was a serious thing to bring praise to God, to bring the prayers of the saints to God. But now, we are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are the sanctuary. Right? In Ezekiel 37, verse 26, it says that it's a joy to have the presence of God among us.
Yes.
That
yes.
The presence of God now rests in us. He is wherever we are. So we say, where is God deserving of his praises? I mean, definitely on Sunday morning when we gather together, this is our sanctuary. This is our time where we meet with God in the presence. But wherever we are, Psalm says, wherever we are, God is deserving of praise.
Amen.
Wherever we are the sanctuary. We carry the presence of God wherever we're. And so now, from within us, the praises of God should flow at all times, in every moment. So where should I praise God? Well, when I'm at home, in my bed, when I'm eating my dinner, when I'm working in my workplace, when I'm driving on the road, when I'm with my friends, when I'm with strangers on the street and saying, hey, they're going to the liquor store. Praise God. You know how great and how wonderful and how awesome He is compared to what you're putting inside of you? Praise God. And wherever we are the sanctuary of God. We are the temples of the Holy Spirit. He deserves the praise wherever we can be. Praise God in His, some people read this and some translations say, instead of just praise God in the sanctuary, but praise God in His holy ones. We are the holy ones of God. We are the representation of Him. God has appeared and does appear in the life of His sanctified ones, of His beloved, of His children. That's you and me.
Amen.
Amen. We are that very image. And we must praise God in our being, with our talents, with everything we do. So when somebody praises us, and sometimes I get this every once in a while. Just this week, I went golfing. It was really fun with some pastors. And, you know, I hit a few good shots. And I don't golf enough to hit good shots, you know. So when they do happen, I'm like, it wasn't me. You know, they're like, man, that was a great shot. It wasn't me at all. You've got an opportunity to praise God. When somebody comes up to you, compliments you for a talent or a skill or a personality trait that you have, hey, it isn't me. I tell people all the time, man, it isn't me that loves my wife the way I should. I mean, it's God in me that loves my wife. I mean, it's God in me that allows me to be able to speak. It's God in me that allows me to manage my workplace the way I do. I mean, it's God. It's not me. It's Him. I have the opportunity to praise the Lord. Let's continue here. Let's continue on this verse 1. First, it's praise God in the sanctuary. Praise God wherever we are. Praise Him in the mighty heavens. In the mighty heavens. Praise Him because of His power. His glory appears in the heavens. Man, if you examine, I love going out in the nature. I'll tell a lot of things about me and Rachel. When we went on our honeymoon, we went out to Tennessee in the mountains, in the Smoky Mountains, you know. And we were out there, and I was like, we're in the middle of this beautiful forest. Can we go on a nature walk? And then the next day, next afternoon, we'll go on another nature. Can we go walking in the forest? Eventually, we got to this place where we went putt-putting. She was like, all right, if we go on a putt-putt, I get to decide, or whoever wins gets to decide, you know, what we're going to do tonight. If I win, I get to go on another nature walk. If she wins, we get to go, you know, watch a movie, go to one of the Dolly Parton dinner theater type things. Rachel won, so we didn't get to go on another nature walk, but I love being in nature. I love, you know, observing God's creation. I love seeing it. His creation, it declares how great, how powerful, and how wonderful He is. Amen? Glory appears in the heavens, in its vastness, in the brightness, in the splendor of it. that those who have their dwelling in the mighty heaven, even the holy angels, they're singing praises to him. They're always before his throne, the elders and all the angels bowing before him, worthy, holy, all the time. We read that in Revelations, right? Who is worthy to open the scroll? It's him. It's the Lamb. Everything in all creation declares his glory. And indeed, within us, our talents, our gifts, the way we uniquely yes. express God, yes. it declares his greatness. Yes. There is no place on heaven or on earth or in heaven that we cannot praise God. We cannot find something to be excited about what our God has done in our lives. And we know we come in here. Sometimes I'm guilty of that, right? I come in on Sunday morning. I come to my time of devotion, and I come heavy-hearted. I come with things that are weighing me down. But, you know, even in those moments, I find that there's power when I praise him. When I find there's something I can muster up praise about. There's something that I can get excited about. There's something I can say, God, you provided this in my life. Yeah, there's something, God, that I can see your fingerprints on, even when things are out of control. There's everything. There's no place on earth. There's no place on earth that we will not be able to find praise for God. In his sanctuary, wherever we are, and in his mighty heavens, wherever we may find ourselves, there's something to praise God. So let's see next thing. What should we praise God for? I can praise God for my clothes. We as little kids and growing up in the church, they used to teach us, all right, what can we praise God for? Praise him for the clothes, for the house, and for the food. I mean, like, we can get that basic. I mean, if you're in that terrible of a situation, hey, there's something. You can praise God for what you have in front of you. I love working. We went to Atlanta as a teenager and worked with some homeless ministry down there in Atlanta. And they would have hundreds of homeless men and women come to this one building, some of them walking miles just so they could praise God. And it's nothing like hanging out with people that have nothing to get an appreciation for what you have. And they were like, they had nothing in the natural to praise God for. But you know what? That was the most jubilant time of praise I've ever had. I mean, they were dancing, and the pastor on Sunday morning, they were doing line dances in the middle of worship. And afterwards, we kind of had a debrief with the pastor. We said, Pastor, do you allow them, line dances, going on? And do you allow them to dance like that? Like, how do you determine what they allow to praise? Because that's how they know how to praise. That's how they know how to express themselves to God. You know, we talked about last week the woman who came before Jesus, and he took the nard of oil and perfume and laid it on his feet and washed it with his hair. And this is a beautiful song. I told you, Alabaster Box, and it's kind of a poetic description of that. Hey, you don't know what they've been through. You don't know what God has delivered them from, and they're just praising God. So the pastor said, I just let them praise God. He said, the only time I stopped them from praising God was one person decided to get on the pole and start dancing, and I said, that's not going to be allowed in the house of God. But praise God with the dance. So what can we praise God for? We got something to praise God for. The psalmist says here, praise him for his acts of power.
Hallelujah.
Praise him for his mighty acts, for his might. For all the instances of his might, the power of his providence, the power of his grace. He has done what he has done in creation. That's why I said I love looking at creation, because I see the power of his word to create, to make things into being. Man, I just sometimes in my prayers, I'm like, well, what I know could be isn't yet. God, would you speak it into being? Because I know you have the power to do so. We're praying over Pastor Jose. We say, hey, the finances aren't there. We're praying because he has the power to do so. He created the world. What is a couple thousand dollars to fund a ministry, right? And I praise him for the government, for the way that he structured things on earth. I praise him because he redeemed the world.
That's right. Hallelujah.
We read that in Revelation. There's nobody else worthy. There is nobody else that could do the open this world. There is nobody else that could redeem the world. He showed his great power and his great might in defeating death and giving us life. Not only did death took him to the grave, right?
That's right.
But it didn't hold him there.
That's right. Hallelujah.
He was greater. He had more power. than the grave. There is nobody else that can redeem us. And that alone deserves our praise.
Amen. Yes.
Right.
You took us out of the miry clay. You took us and from slavery, and you made us children of God. His power for his own church, particularly his children. Come on, there's something we can get excited about. Praise him for his mighty power.
Yeah.
Psalmist continues. Praise him for the glory and the majesty of his being. Praise him for who he is. That he is holy.
That's right.
That he is pure. Compared to me, right? I think about this all the time. Man, compared to me, God, you are way holy. You are perfect. You are wonderful. God, you are patient beyond belief. I can't imagine. I can't.
Yeah.
I can't. That quality doesn't always come out of me.
Amen.
But God, you are patient with me. Mm-hmm. God, you are full of mercy. God, your love, I truly experience that your love, it endures forever. The majesty of his being, praise him. Praise him according to his excellent greatness, according to the multitude of his magnificence.
Wow.
Not that our praises can bear any proportion to God's greatness. My words, they get exhausted when I'm trying to praise God. There's something more I want to say to you, God, but I can't even express it. That's how great you are. You ever consider that in a prayer? I don't even know what to say more about you, God. You hear that? Amazing.
Amen.
You're that good.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
For God and his greatness is infinite. He's greater than we can even express or conceive. We must raise our expression to the highest degree so that we can even come close to attaining what he's worthy of. So don't ever be afraid of saying too much. We don't have to be afraid when we're out on the street somewhere and we're talking to somebody. We can't be afraid of saying too much in our praise of God. When we're out on the street, when we're witnessing about him. We can't even get close to saying too much about how great he is. How much worth he has, how much greater he would be than any other earthly thing that people could praise, right? We cannot speak hyperbolically of God. We can't say too much about him. All the danger is that we say too little. That we have done our utmost, we must own that though we have praised him in consideration of, yet not in proportion to, his excellent greatness. We must own that we have praised him in consideration of who he is, but not yet in proportion to his excellent greatness. There's still room for him to be praised. There's still room for him to get glory in our life. There's still room for him to receive it. We praise him for his acts of power. We praise him for his surpassing greatness, his greatness that goes beyond anything we can hope or imagine. I love that prayer that Paul prays in Ephesians. And he can do exceedingly above and beyond anything we could hope or imagine. I mean, I always say this. I was a Barney kid, right? I love imagining. I can imagine a lot of things. He's even greater than that. He's even more wonderful than that. He brings a greater peace. Man, help me to believe that. Some of them don't mean that. Help us to believe, God, that you are greater than anything we face in our life. God, you are greater than anything. You are greater than everything. God, your greatness, Lord, we cannot stop speaking how great you are. God, help us to believe that in our hearts. Because, Lord, when we believe that in our hearts, Father, I know, God, the expressions of our praise would be unending.
Yes.
Father, help us to believe how great and how wonderful you are. So how should we praise him? The psalmist continues in verse 33 and verse 5, right? Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with the tambour and the dancing. Praise him with the strings and the pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with the resounding cymbals. Man, with all kinds of musical instruments, they are to be used to praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Man, join us in praying. We're believing that our expression of praise on Sunday morning will be full of music and sound that He's worthy of. We know, or we should know, that the heart of the psalmist is full of praise. And how desirous the psalmist was that he would receive all that he could. And all the talents and all the gifts. The psalmist said, man, he deserves it. In any kind of music, in any kind of praise, in any kind of voice. Man, that gets me excited because I'm included in that. Even if I can't sing on key and my harmonies aren't perfect, man, I'm included. Everything that he had, man, let's praise God with it. With the clapping, whether it's on beat or off key. Hey, let's praise God. He is deserving of it. It's also the psalmist that he's describing. I see that the praise that he deserved, that God deserves, that we should spare no effort in it. Man, I'm gonna exercise that. I'm gonna spare no effort in making sure that God gets what He deserves. I'm gonna clap. I know Him. Man, I'm gonna shout. I'm gonna sing. I'm gonna share. I'm gonna talk. I'm gonna get it out because I'm gonna spare no effort. Just a song, man. Praise Him with everything you've got. All the different instruments. Man. Let the best music come forth to God ears, to devote to God out of a melodious heart, out of a joyful heart. Praise God with a strong faith. Praise Him with holy love and delight. Wow, God, You're so wonderful. Praise Him with the entire confidence that we have in Christ. The confidence that, hey, I do stand on a solid ground, and there's nothing that can shake me. There's nothing that can come against me. Man, I want to praise God with the confidence that I have that I am a child of God because of the work that Christ has done. I'm going to praise Him because I am more than a conqueror, even when my circumstances and the environment around me doesn't say so. I'm going to praise Him in the confidence that I have that Christ is on my side and He's interceding on my behalf. That He is, like Pastor said, cheering me on. He's going. Man, you can do it. Christ is on our side. Praise God because we have the one that conquered all with us. And praise Him because we have confidence in what He and who He is and what He's done. Praise Him because we believe that we have triumphed over darkness.
Amen. Yes.
The darkness that we once knew, it has no hold on us any longer. The darkness that still tries to grab us at its feet, it tries to hold us down, it has no grip on us. It has been defeated. Praise Him because we have triumphed over it. Because we have hope that the gospel says that no matter what we're going through, no matter what life has thrown our way, no matter what we find ourselves in, that because of the gospel we have hope that that has been defeated, that we have conquered it, and that we are more than whatever earth says about us. Praise Him because we have triumphed over the darkness. Praise Him because He earnestly desires towards us, that we have full satisfaction in Him. Jesus is so much better than anything I once found myself in. Yes. He satisfies me more deeply. He gives me a deeper peace. Man, He conquers me. He wraps me in His love. Man, I have full satisfaction in Him. There's times that I forget that. Praise Him because I can find that in Him. Praise Him because of His beautiful and glorious and truthful and powerful commands. Praise Him because His ways are perfect.
Yes.
I know when I walk my own way and when I try to do my own thing, it leads to destruction. It leads to mishaps. It leads to it leads to destruction. But praise Him because His commands are perfect.
Amen.
Wow, God, Your ways are amazing. They're pure and they're right. And every time I follow Your leading, it always goes right for me. It always goes good with me, God, when I obey Your command. Praise Him because of His wonderful command. Praise Him because of how amazing and how wonderful His love is. His great goodness towards me. God, I didn't deserve it. Jesus, I didn't deserve You to take my place. Man, I wasn't worth it. I was nothing. God, I praise you because of your goodness towards me. God, I praise you that you provided me. I mean, when we were little kids, we say praise him because of the food that you have, the clothes you have. Man, praise you because I don't deserve the clothes that I have. God, I don't deserve the food that I don't deserve the job that I have. I don't deserve the talent that I have. God, you are so good to me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise him because I have a hope and an expectation of his kingdom coming. Praise him because I have a hope that anger is going to cease, that disease is going to cease, that hate is going to cease, that there's going to be a place where his perfect presence, where there's nothing that can get away in a way of me experiencing, that I get to be face to face with him forever. And ever. Praise him because all these earthly things are going to wash away. There's going to be a new government established, and it's going to be established by his glory. It's going to be a kingdom like no other. It's going to be a kingdom of peace and of joy and of full health, of whole prosperity. We're going to walk on streets of gold.
Yeah.
Come on.
We
have a hope.
Yes.
There's something for us to praise him about.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
Praise him with the various instruments being used. Praise God. Mm-hmm. It should be done with perfect exactness. It should be done with perfect harmony. There should be nothing that hinders us from praising God. Romans 15:16 says that we should praise him with one mind, with one mouth. We should glorify God. Man, one sound. You've been around Catholic Church for too long. We believe that we are one church. Every tongue, tribe, nation are represented here together, praising God. We want to be the church that represents that glorious heaven, picture of heaven, where everybody's come together in one, unified, singing, God, you are great. God, you are worthy. God, you are awesome. God, you deserve it all. How shall we praise God? With everything we got. For every reason.
Right.
Every gift and talent. With every sound that we can make. Praise him. Psalmist continues. To who must praise God? Who is it that should be praising God? Verse 6 gives us this amazing answer. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm still breathing. You guys still breathing?
Yeah.
Amen.
Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. He begins in the psalm by saying everybody that has a place in the sanctuary, everybody that had service in the temple, especially remember this was again at a time where there was still a temple of God that people would come to praise God at. But he concludes at the very end that all children, every man, every woman, all beings should praise God. And I love this because it even points to a future reality that had not yet taken place. When we look at the New Testament, we get excited about the fact that it says that there is no man, no female, no Greek, no Jew or Gentile, that we're all one. We get excited about the fact that Jesus comes and he brings the gospel message to everybody, that it wasn't just about one nation or one people group, but it was about all nations and all people groups. That would include the Gentiles. But what is exciting when we begin to study the Old Testament is we find that this wasn't a new idea. It wasn't just a new idea that all people were going to praise God. It wasn't a new idea. There is provisions over and over again for the nation to come and to praise God too. And again, we find it here in the psalm. Let everything that has breath. But everybody, this is for everybody. That's me. That's you. That's our neighbors. That's the people on the street. That's all my family. That's everybody. That's like I said, I love looking at the creation. That one of the times we were walking in the woods, and I want to miss the name of the type of woodpecker it was. I forget the first name, but anyway, it was a woodpecker. But you got little woodpeckers you get all the time around here, right? The little woodpeckers, you can look out, you see them, they're probably yay big, knocking on the wood. But we were out in the middle of this forest, and we saw this type of woodpecker. And it was about 3 feet tall. It was like, it was walking on the ground. It was the most beautiful bird I've ever seen that close. And, you know, I'm all excited. I'm like trying to follow it. And I was just in awe of this creature. I love studying a little bit of biology, you know, and just like, God, you're so awesome. I mean, like, everything that has breath, it just declares how great and how wonderful and how awesome he is. I love being outside. I just, God, I can see you everywhere. That everything that has breath, everything that has breath, everything in heaven and on earth, it declares how great, how wonderful, how glorious our God in heaven is. In Jerusalem, there was essence that arise, and they were often represented, essence often represented the Bible prayers, and also represents praise unto God. Something that everything that has breath must includes the inferior creatures. I believe that it does, that it includes every creature that God made. They praise God according to their capacity. The singing birds, they sort out praising God. The word says that rocks will cry out even if I don't praise God. I mean, they used to sing that song, right? There's a guy that sang it with us a couple Saturdays ago. There ain't no rock but a praise in my place. I mean, like, I know it does because it's amazing. It was made by his hands, right? It was formed by his word. But I mean, it's not going to take my place. I want to get excited about who he is. I want to praise him. John has this vision in Revelations, and he said that every creature which is in heaven and on earth and under the earth, they were all joining in this harmonious song of praise to God. Genesis chapter 2 says that God breathed life, and he breathed it into our souls, and we are alive today because of him. And that alone, again, is something that we can praise God for. I have the breath of life. The gospel is going to be preached to every living creature, to every human creature. I can't imagine, I don't know every bird, I don't know where that is in theology. Every creature is going to be preached, is going to know that Jesus is Lord, that he is above all, that he has redeemed the world. To every human creature, our prayers in Lamentations 3, verse 56 is also called our breathings. Our prayers to God are our breathings, are our breath. Let everybody who breathes towards, everybody who prays toward God, may they praise him. Pray that our prayers, that our praises would be like a perfume to God. Be like an essence. We sing the song, "You're Worthy of It All." This day and night, night and day, the incense arises. It's talking about these prayers, it's talking about these praises that we're breathing unto God. There's psalms that describe it in a poetic way, that let it be a sweet aroma to God's nostrils, the praises and the prayers that we pray to him. Our prayers can be praised to him. Our prayers tell of how great God is. Some people used to say, maybe a little bit guilt-ridden, but they would say, you know, you can tell a man or a woman's faith by their prayers. You can tell what they believe about God by their prayers, right? Are you guilty of praying? People would ask, are you guilty of praying little prayers? How does God get praise from my prayers? God, bless this day. I pray this food nourishes my body. Amen. That's the simplest prayer we can pray. Is that the only prayer that we pray? Does our prayers give God praise? God, I'm believing right now. I can pray this right now. God, I believe right now. for Houston and all the areas of Texas right now that are under floodwaters, and people have seen wasted their lives wasting away through water damage and all sorts of millions of dollars and lives being taken away because of all this flooding. God, I believe that you are powerful enough, Father, to reduce the floodwaters. Lord God, to redeem this whole situation. Father, Lord, to bring light, Father, Lord, into every city affected by this. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we believe, God, that you can do something miraculous out of something destructive. So, Father, Lord, I pray that you would do so in Jesus' name. Our prayers give praise to God. How much do we believe God is able? I believe, God, when we have healing, I don't just pray a simple prayer for it. I mean, I believe that God can bring healing into our lives. And this week, Angel, you talked about that affection. I mean, I pray for Angel. Why? Because I believe that God can do it. And when I believe, when we believe in prayer that God can do these impossible things that he says he can do, it brings praises to him. It exalts him.
That's
right. That's how prayers bring praise to God. And I can't wait till I breathe my last breath here. Because then, eternally, I get to breathe in the praises of God all the time around his presence. And God's praises will be freer, it'll be better than air. I mean, I'm with him in his presence. The first three, the Psalms, if we get into studying Psalms, it's broken down into five different books, five different divisions. And so the third one is called Amen and Amen. Basically, if we study the word Amen, right, it means let it be so. Let it be. Well, amen, amen. The fourth one is called Amen, let it be so, hallelujah. You guys like that? It's a nice churchy word, hallelujah, right? And then this last portion of Psalms that we're in, that 150 is in, it's called only hallelujah. You guys know what hallelujah means? I say it a lot. Like on Sunday mornings, you hear us like shouting, hallelujah! It's amazing! Hallelujah! God, you're good! Hallelujah! What does hallelujah mean? Praise be to God. God, you're deserving of it. Hallelujah! You're awesome! Hallelujah! God, you deserve it. God, you deserve all the praise. The great hallelujah. I want to join in. Join in with the praises of all creation. Join in and singing, God, you're worthy. God, praise be to your name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. With every ounce of my being, every second of the day, hallelujah, you deserve it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The nearer we come to God, the more we study his word, the greater our praises, the more full our praises will become. Amen. If you're sitting here this morning, like, I don't know what Andrew's all excited about. Get closer to God.
Amen.
Get in his word. Get to know him. And our praises will become fuller and fuller. I loved it. I used to work at a retirement home when I was in college. And I was all. It was a retirement home for ministers and missionaries and different saints from here, and they were excited about God. They're breathing their lives, but they didn't even know what day it was sometimes. But you know what? They talking about God, and all of a sudden, praise began to grow because they knew, I'm closer than you are, Andy, to seeing God face to face, and I know how great and how wonderful he is.
That's
I've been examining him for years, Andy, and I know that he's great. He deserves. The longer we spend with him, the more full our praises become. One day in the great New Jerusalem, according to Revelation 21 and verse 18, there's going to be gold that lays on the ground. There's going to be pearls on gates. There's going to be a river that rushes. There's going to be a tree of life that we can partake of. There's going to be a great feast. But we look forward to those great and intimate glories.
Yes.
He is also here with us right now.
That's right.
He walks with us. He talks with us. He breathes around us. His power is demonstrated.
Yeah.
He's for us. He's not against us. Though now we see with maybe weary, where are some praises? I pray that we are so infected with the serum of praise that we will not end to seeing how great and how glorious He is. Let us often take the pleasure of thinking that we get to partake in these glories of heaven. I know that God will quicken us as we observe who He is, as we continue to draw near to Him. He will quicken us to praise.
Amen.
You can't stop but praise when you're around His great and wonderful glorious goodness. And we will one day spend an eternity in joyful hallelujahs.
Yes.
Revelations 19, 1 and 3. We'll sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. He is worthy. Can we stand this morning? If you're in this room this morning, and you may find, as we talked about in the middle, that you may find your heart is full of unbelief still. Mm-hmm. Unbelief to know that He deserves all things. I pray that this morning, as we studied Psalms 150, that your heart was encouraged, that your heart would find in Him something to be thankful for, something to give Him praise, something to get excited about. And if this morning you say, I find myself in that place, Andrew, I need the encouragement of the saints, I need some grace, I need some help this morning, we're being reminded of how great and how deserving God's praise is. I want to give that opportunity today. It's a great moment when we can stand before God, before our brothers and sisters, and to admit, yeah, I need to be reminded of how great He is. Yeah, I'm struggling in the moment to find something to praise God about. And because in that moment, we can join around you. We can pray and encourage you and remind you of how good He is. Not a reminder as in a scolding, but a reminder as in a lifting up and saying, just remember how great He is. Remember how strong He is. Remember that no matter what you're facing, He's greater, He's better, He can make it through, He conquered that. And so this morning, if you find yourself in a place of unbelief, hey, and you need to tell God, help me to believe how great You are. Remind me in this moment, God, that You are better, that Your peace is greater, that Your comfort is better, that Your commands are right. And if that's you this morning, you say, Andrew, I need some encouragement. I need a reminder of how great and how worthy God is of praise. I want to invite you to raise your hand. Before God, saying, God, I want to be honest with you. I need a reminder of how great You are.
Yeah.
Thank You for those hands. I just want to pause a moment.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Thank You for those hands.
Hallelujah.
And we raise them before God. We say, God, yes. Help me. Help me to have a fuller picture of who You are. We haven't done this in a while, but I want to take a moment. I want to gather around Kevin and around Evan this morning. They raised their hand, Evan, this morning. They said, yeah, I need some encouragement. I want the saints to gather around. Let's gather around. Gather around Evan.